Hi everyone. My name is Nikita Divissenko and I'm a research associate at the Florence School of Banking and Finance. Today we are going to talk about open banking. Open banking is essentially about information exchange within the retail banking environment. It is based on permissioned customer data shared by banks with a third-party developers and firms. As such, open banking is commonly understood as information exchange between service providers to enable building of applications and to offer new services for more efficient and transparent retail banking. A combination of three forces enables open banking innovation. First, it is the innovativeness of the supply side of the market. Second, the new technologies or the technological change. And third, the changing demand. To better understand the benefits but also the challenges of open banking, I suggest to look closer at the key features of each of these three forces. First, innovating firms, to use Schumpeterian terms, are at the core of banking innovation from the supply side perspective. Producers on the supply side, so these are banks and the so-called third-party providers, who are offering payment initiation and account aggregation types of services as alternatives to traditional payment or online banking experiences, employ customer-centricity as their key model for innovation. This means a different, compared to traditional mode of innovation, a different and a closer engagement with customer through techniques such as the use of touch points or feedback loops. Both the increased importance of customer input in the process of innovation as well as leveraging on the larger amounts of transaction data relies on the most recent technology. The innovating banking platforms under open banking framework are based on, first of all, open application programming interfaces, the open APIs, that allow banks and third-party providers to collaborate and create value. In addition to this technology, also AI and data analytics tools have key importance for open banking, as well as cloud technologies and technologies enhancing security, which are used in authentication, authorization procedures, as well as in controlling access under the open banking paradigm. Finally, in addition to the developments in business strategies and advances in technology, successful innovation in open banking also requires market demand. And indeed, open banking has been largely a demand-driven phenomenon with the changing preferences and needs of consumers as a catalyst for innovation. From the consumer perspective, the benefits of open banking are considered to be plenty. Information exchange and data sharing between banks and third-party providers has been enabling a variety of new services meeting the changing demand for faster, cheaper, and more convenient digital services. Open banking offers consumers an easier overview of their recurrent expenses such as subscription services, and it also brings together an overview on their loans, savings and pensions, as well as provides an opportunity for faster payments between consumers and between accounts in different banks, and also a better overview of spending. The notion of consumer control over their own data has been deemed central to open banking. That is, consumer control over the instances, as well as the type and the amount of data that is shared. Consumer control and ownership of their transaction data has been equally emphasized by both service providers, traditional and new service providers, as well as regulators and consumer organizations. The demand for open banking has significantly increased in the COVID-19 pandemic. Although, according to the recent reports, consumers want to have more access to data about their spending, they are still often reluctant to do so and to share their data with non-banking third-party service providers. This points to a number of challenges for open banking. From a broader industry perspective, the key challenges to open banking include interoperability of information exchange that requires standardization of open APIs, but also enhancing customer awareness and education that would make consumers, on the one hand, aware of these new opportunities, and on the other hand, ensure secure behavior when consumers are exercising their control over financial and personal data in the open banking environment. These challenges have been addressed by industry-led initiatives aimed at the development of industry-wide standards and best practices, but also by regulation. The open banking framework in the EU is regulated by the Revised Payment Services Directive that was adopted in 2015 and contributed to the development of open banking by enhancing the competitive environment in the retail payments industry and also mandating some standardization to ensure interoperability and to introduce minimum security and consumer protection standards. Open banking and its regulation in the EU provided a blueprint for further policies aimed at harnessing data-driven innovation. EU digital finance strategy aims at promoting further business-to-business data sharing in the EU financial sector and beyond to enhance consumer benefits. Known as open finance as the next step in the evolution of open banking, the objective of the policymakers is to provide consumers with a wider range of financial products and services to ensure greater control over their data and enhance consumer engagement with the financial services and also to empower better financial decisions. Understanding the open banking innovation from the perspective of the three forces that enable it, which are the supply side, the technological change, and the changing demand, is crucial for further policy and regulatory action. On the one hand, this enables a better understanding of challenges and obstacles to open banking. On the other hand, this underlines the importance of coordinated action between industry stakeholders, policymakers, regulators, and supervisors when these actors are aiming at enhancing the benefits of consumers when sharing their data.